Electric cars look like normal cars only when you see it from outside. But if you go inside it, start driving it, you can feel the car is quiet and you can observe the difference. Let's take a closer look at the inner workings of battery electric vehicles. All electric vehicles, also referred to as battery electric vehicles, BEVs. Unlike gas-powered vehicles, electric vehicles do not require internal combustion engine to operate. They are outfitted by one or more electric motors and rechargeable battery pack. EVs move along our roadways without burning up gasoline or producing harmful exhaust emissions, while generating less noise pollution. If we say in simple words, the gasoline engine is replaced by an electric motor. The controller is the power source for the electric motor. And the controller gets its power from an array of rechargeable batteries. A few things that you won't find in an electric vehicle are gasoline and a gas tank, an engine, a complex transmission, and air intake or exhaust systems. Here's a basic rundown of how electric cars work. EVs receive energy from a charging station and store the energy in its battery. When pedal of the car is pressed, then controller takes and regulates electrical energy from battery and inverter. With the controller set, the inverter then sends a certain amount of electrical energy to the motor, according to the depth of pressure on the pedal. Electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Rotation: the rotation of the motor rotor rotates the transmission, so the wheels turn and then the car moves. Breaking down the key components that make up an electric car is essential to understanding how they run. These basic key components include a charging port, inverter, electric traction motor, electric powertrain, and traction battery pack. Charging port. An electric vehicle's charge port allows the battery pack to receive energy from an external power source. These power sources are referred to as electric vehicle supply equipment, more commonly known as a charging station. Charging occurs when an electric vehicle supply equipment is plugged into an EV's charge port at a private residence or commercial charging station. The three main ways to charge a battery electric vehicle: Level 1 AC charging, Level 2 AC charging, and Level 3 DC fast charging. Level 1 charging, using a 120-volt outlet. Level 1 home charging requires no special equipment, but it provides the slowest charging cycle. This charging method provides an EV with 2 to 5 miles of range each hour of charging. Typically, charging time takes 8 to 10 hours depending on model. Level 2 charging, using a 220 or 240-volt outlet. Level 2 charging requires specialty equipment in home or use of a public charging station. Also works for all battery electric vehicles. This electric vehicle supply equipment or EVSA is much faster than a level 1 charger, also compatible with all plug-in vehicles, and provides 10 to 25 miles of range each hour of charging. Level 3 DC fast charging. In this type electric vehicle supply equipment, EVSA converts AC electricity into DC electricity within the charging station, which delivers energy into an EV's battery pack faster than level 1 and 2 chargers. These fast charging stations can charge a traction battery pack from 15 to 45 minutes, but they are only compatible with certain plug-in vehicles. Inverter. Electric vehicle inverters change the battery pack's flow of electrons from a direct current DC into an alternating current AC, which is then used to power the electric traction motor. Because lithium-ion batteries can only accept DC power, and because electric traction motors require AC power to function, inverters are necessary components for EVs. Inverters are also used to control the frequency of the AC power being sent to the motor, so they play a direct role in controlling an EV's speed. Electric traction motor. Receiving electricity from the inverter. The electric traction motor provides the power that makes an electric vehicle move. Electric traction motors are commonly powered by an alternating current, as this type of motor is more efficient and reliable than a DC motor. When AC electrons reach the motor via the inverter, they generate a rotating magnetic field that causes the motor to turn. Electric traction motors are highly efficient and powerful, as they do not feature multiple gears to shift between like an internal combustion engine. Power from the pedal to the engine is almost immediate. Electric powertrain. An electric vehicle's powertrain encompasses the entire high-voltage electrical system that allows the vehicle to operate. An electric powertrain is commonly made up of an inverter, electric traction motor, reduction drive, and the traction battery. These electric powertrains are lightweight, compact, and provide very little vibration with instant torque. Many inverters in electric powertrains can even recover displaced energy during deceleration. This process is known as regeneration, transferring unused AC power during braking into DC power that can be stored back in the battery pack. Traction battery pack. An electric vehicle's traction battery pack's main function is to store energy gathered from the grid during charging. This energy is then used to power the vehicle's motor and all other electrical components. Almost all EVs on the road today utilize lithium-ion batteries within their traction battery pack, as they have one of the highest energy densities of any battery available. Lithium-ion batteries also produce larger currents and require little maintenance compared to other battery types. Some EVs also feature an auxiliary battery that strictly powers vehicle accessories, rather than drawing from the traction battery pack to power all components. Other components that are included in EVs that help them operate are thermal management system, transmission, and DC to DC converter. Thermal management system. If equipped, a thermal management system can extend the life of the battery pack, cooling it while fast charging, and on hot days, and even warming it up on cold days or to prepare for fast charging. The TMS works with the BMS to create optimal battery conditions. Transmission. This one of electric car parts that to converts higher voltage DC power from the traction battery pack to the lower voltage DC power needed to run vehicle accessories and recharge the auxiliary battery. DC to DC converter. It is one of electric car parts that converts higher voltage DC power from the traction battery pack to the lower voltage DC power needed to run vehicle accessories and recharge the auxiliary battery. Do electric cars use regenerative braking? Yes, currently all electric and hybrid vehicles in the US use regenerative braking systems. In some electric vehicles, regenerative braking system may not be available, but mostly have. Electric vehicles run off the stored charge built up once they are plugged into an outlet or charging station. Regenerative braking systems are used to top off the battery and are very useful for electric and hybrid cars. This mechanism retrieves some of the energy that's lost during braking and in return uses the energy as a mechanism to recharge the battery, and thereby improve not just the efficiency but also increases the range. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.